Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this introductory video class of DIP, we will study what is digital image processing. So as this is a very first video class for this particular subject, let me give you one rule or one law. Remember that everything is there in the name. See, someone has said that what is there in the name, and I am just reversing the statement. I am saying that everything is there in the name. Why? Because many a times I have observed in the exam that students have dilemma in their mind that how to start writing the answer, what to write in the very beginning. So at that time, remember, everything is there in the name, and you start explaining or writing the answer with the name itself or the definition itself. Then continuously there will be a flow of ideas from your mind and you will write your answers smoothly, right? So here, what is the name? Here name is digital image processing, right? What is digital? Digital means something that is fixed or discrete with respect to time. What is image? Image is a picture or a photograph or a diagram. And what is processing? Processing means altering or manipulating, right? So digital image processing means altering or manipulating digital images. Now, very first question comes in your mind is, why do we need to do processing? See, we do processing for our convenience, to make the image more clear or to extract some useful information from the image. So this will be the contents of our class. So let us start with the image and a digital image, right? So what is analog image? The images that were taken by the photographic film camera before many years were analog images, which were varying continuously with respect to time, and the information was stored on magnetic tapes, right? But now those analog cameras have gone extinct due to digitization. Currently we only use digital cameras and digital images. So those analog cameras has gone extinct, like the audio cassettes, right? Before few years. That is an analog image. And what is digital image? Digital image is one that is consisting of pixels or picture elements. We will just understand what are picture elements or pixels. So what is an image? Image is an pictorial representation of someone or something, right? So if you see the picture of this particular rose and you want to define it, or you want to write something on this, okay, how will you write? You will write that this picture is of a rose which is very beautiful. It has got some dark pink petals, it has got some light pink petals. The filaments are yellow colored, the leaves are green, some of the leaves are yellowish green, some of the leaves are dark green, some of the leaves are half dry. You will explain the soil, you will explain the background of the image and everything, right? So if you want to explain perfectly, you may need 1,000 words or even more than that, right? And therefore someone has truly said that the picture is worth 1,000 words. So in place of the 1,000 words, if you keep this one image, it will explain everything. So an image is a two-dimensional function, mathematically f of xy, where x and y are the spatial or plane coordinates, and the amplitude of f at any pair of coordinates x and y is called the intensity of the image at that level. So x is, say, for different rows, y is for different columns, and f is the intensity value or amplitude value or gray level value of that particular point for a black and white image. So if x, y and the amplitude values of f are finite and discrete, we call the image as a digital image. The values will be fixed, right? A digital image is composed of finite number of elements called the pixels or picture elements, each of which has a particular location and value. Nowadays we are hearing these pixels many times, right? For example, say the picture is 12 megapixel, that means that picture has got 12 into 10 raised to 6 pixels inside it, right? And each pixel will be carrying one information, one particular information of that image. So that particular image is called a digital image. For example, say this particular point is having a value f of x0 y0. This means that x0 y0 is this particular location, and f is the intensity value of that particular location, right? If it is f of x1 y1, then it is the intensity value of some particular other location. So consider the following image, which is of, say, 27, 24 cross 23, 36 pixels, and it is a 2D function or a matrix with rows and columns like this. In 8-bit representation, the pixel intensity values, okay, for monochrome image ranges from 0, that is black, to 255, that is white, right? So this is the first pixel, we name it as F11, right? So the pixel intensity value over here, F11, is equal to 33. Okay, 11 is the pixel location. So here the value is 33, which is near to 0, right? That means it is much dark. Whereas here F27, 24, 23, 36, the last pixel, is having the value 83, right, which is brighter as compared to this, and therefore the value is 83. If you take this particular square block or matrix, it will be having values something like this. So this is how we break the digital image in number of pixels, but the image seems to be continuous to us, okay? But actually when you zoom it, you will find out each pixel separately. So here I have zoomed this particular portion of the image, and you can see one pixel is one square like this, right? A yellow colored pixel is shown over here for the yellow filament of this rose, right? So remember this thing, that digitization implies that a digital image is an approximation of a real scene. So it is an approximation, it is not exactly the real scene, but when you increase the approximation to a large value, okay, it seems to be real or same as original. So this is a conventional coordinate for image representation. M is the number of rows, you can say, right? And N is the number of columns, right? Or you can say X is the number of rows and Y is the number of columns. We can represent one pixel by F of XY or F of M N, right? Here it is the origin, the 0,0 point, and this is the final point of this particular image. And each pixel is represented by k bit. So if it is 8-bit image, then the pixel will be having 2^2 k different values. If it is 8-bit, it will be equal to 2^8, which is equal to 256. Each pixel will be having one value out of 256 different values, right? Whereas if k is equal to 1, then it will be equal to, the values will be equal to 2^1, which is equal to 2. So it will be having only two different values. Which are these two different values? Obviously 0 and 1. So 0 will be for black and 1 will be represented by white color, right? So such an image is known as a binary image, right? Whereas for 8-bit image, it has got 256 different values. That means 0 to 255. 0 is black and 255 is white, and the in-between values are different shades of gray, okay? So let us go ahead and see different types of digital images. What is intensity image? Intensity image or monochrome image is having each pixel corresponding to light intensity, which is normally represented in gray scale or gray level. For this image, if you zoom this particular portion, right, it comes out to be like this. In this portion, if you zoom out this much, it will come out to be like this. And this will be different values of intensity for these particular pixels, right? This pixel is having value 10, nearer to 0 as it is dark, and this is having value 28, right? Why? Because it is bright. Next is a color image or a RGB image, right? So color image or RGB image is represented by different colors, right? Here each pixel contains a vector representing red, green and blue components, and the different pixels will be represented by a vector that is representing red, green and blue, all the three components. So that is color image. Next is a binary image or a black and white image. So here each pixel contains only one bit, okay, where one represents white and zero represents black. The binary image will be like this, okay. The black will be represented by zeros and the white will be represented by ones. The next type is an index image. For the index image, each pixel contains index number pointing to a color in a color table. For example, say for index number 4, this 4, right? The color value is 0.5 for red, 0.5 for green and 0.5 for blue. So here each pixel contains an index number pointing to a color in a color table. Okay, or you can say this is a type of encoding. That is already done. Let's go ahead and understand what is image processing. See, image processing is a manipulation of images by brain or computers. For example, your eyes see some object and it sends the signal to your brain. Okay, and your brain takes some action. That is known as human image processing. Whereas for digital image processing, what we do? We do the manipulation of images by using computers, right? In place of the eye, you use a camera to capture the image and then the image is given to the computer and computer will process that particular image. So this is known as image processing. So processing done by smartphones, digital cameras, computers, all are digital image processing. We are not doing analog image processing nowadays, right? So the image processing, you can further classify into two types, analog image processing and digital image processing. The example of analog image processing is the processing of a CRT TV images. Before few years, we were using CRT TVs like this, in which there are different knobs for controlling contrast or brightness, for varying the contrast or brightness. So here we were doing the processing of this image that was analog in nature. This TV is not a digital TV, it is an analog TV, right? So this example of processing CRT TV image is an example of analog image processing. Whereas example of digital image processing is shown here. You can see here one picture that is little bit faded out and not much clear, and you process this image using PC or smartphone, right? You will obtain a better image. So such a processing is known as digital image processing. So let us define precisely what is digital image processing. Digital image processing is a method to perform some operations on a digital image in order to get enhanced image or extract some useful information from it. So we are obtaining enhanced image or we extract some useful information from that particular image. So the motivation or purposes behind digital image processing is improvement of picture information for human interpretation and storage, transmission and representation of digital data for machine perception is possible in digital image processing. So you can understand that digital image processing will be having all the advantages of digital signal, right? You can store it easily, you can transmit it easily. Processing of digital data is very fast and machine can easily percept it, right? Let us see some examples of digital image processing. See, this is the original image. You can convert this image to a mirror image like this. You can convert the image into a monochrome image or a grayscale image like this. Or you can even convert the image into a binary image like this. Okay, there are only two levels. You can even get the negative of this monochrome image. You can get the red image from the original image using digital image processing, or green image or blue image using the digital image processing. You can blur the image using digital image processing like this. And you can even get the negative of the original image, original color image like this using digital image processing. And not only this, you can do image segmentation, you can do edge detection, you can do filtering, you can do extraction, you can do number of processes using digital image processing, which you'll be learning in this particular subject, right? Next, let us understand different types of digital image processing. So digital image processing can be of three types: low level processing, mid level processing and high level processing. So low level processing includes primitive operations such as noise reduction, image enhancement, sharpening, etc. So for low level digital image processing, the inputs and outputs are images. Next is mid level processing. So for mid level processing, it includes image segmentation, classification of individual objects. The inputs are images, but outputs are attributes or features of images. For example, edges of the image. So mid level image processing is higher as compared to low level processing. Okay. What is high level image processing? High level image processing involves making sense of recognized object and performing functions associated with visions, right? As we humans do. For example, for high level image processing, we are doing automatic character recognition or automatic number plate recognition. So these all includes high level image processing. So high level image processing obviously will be requiring more processing power and memory as compared to mid level and low level image processing. Finally, discuss some applications of digital image processing. So digital image processing is used in biometrics for automatic recognition of some person or features of some person. For example, Aadhaar card, right? We are using biometrics, that is digital image processing. We are using digital image processing for vehicle number plate recognition. We are using digital image processing for CBIR, that is content based image retrieval system, used for searching digital images in large database. For example, you are searching some image on a internet, right? Digital image processing is used in steganography. What is the meaning of steganography? Steganography is the art of hiding information. So you can hide some secret information inside the image and send the image. Okay, that is known as steganography. We are using digital image processing for medical imaging. We are using digital image processing for object recognition. For example, you have a fruit dish. Out of that dish, you want to recognize apple. So you can do that using digital image processing. And of course, you can use digital image processing for image enhancement and noise removal also, as we have already seen, right? So such numerous applications are there of digital image processing. Getting it, right? So that is all for this video lecture. I hope you have gained a good knowledge from this video lecture. In the next video lecture, we will study the human visual system and different elements of digital image processing. Thank you very much.